Good afternoon. Today's topic is tour of swing, and you are going to use Java to implement the swing. Now, introduction. Java swing is a part of Java foundation classes. So now, what is this foundation classes? These classes are a set of GUI, that is graphic user interface components, which simplify the development of desktop application. That is used to create window-based applications. So swing is very helpful for our window-based application implementation. Now it is built on the top of AWT, okay, Abstract Windowing Toolkit. We already covered this topic, and you also done some assignments on this, and entirely written in Java. Now Java Swing provides better lightweight components than AWT. Okay, and the javax.swing package provides the Java Swing related classes, that is J button, J text field, J text area. That is already you know, you are familiar with button, text field, just those are with integrated with J, and this is our swing. Now AWT versus swing, what is this? Since it is a better development over or on AWT, so always there is a comparison. Now AWT components are platform dependent. Obviously you already do this, that's why you know. But Java Swing components are platform independent. Now AWT components are heavyweight, Swing components are lightweight. And AWT doesn't support pluggable look and feel, whereas Swing supports pluggable look and feel. Now AWT provides less components than Swing. Swing provides many more components, and especially color chooser, temp, that is some coloring components are there, which is very helpful to make more effective Windows applications. Now AWT doesn't follow MVC. MVC, what is MVC? That is Model View Controller, where model represents data, view representation, controller acts as an interface between model and view, but Swing follow MVC. Now this is hierarchy of swing classes. Look in this picture, there are some at the end of your this picture is showing the frame and dialogue. We will use this frame and dialogue whenever we are going to implement some application. We need some frame. Okay, and on this frame, that is our container, and on this container the components are applicable. So as a container we are going to use generally J frame for swing, and the J components are in this picture, the left hand side, right hand side. Components are listed there, that is J label, J list, J table, etc. And at the end of the right corner there is a J button, okay, and arrow is there for abstraction button, abstract button. It implies that abstract button actually implemented by J button, and we are directly going to use this J button. And so we are going to finally create or using all of this using our object, since Java is totally object oriented program. Now Java Swing examples, we are going to show some code thoroughly, that is we are going to go through to some code thoroughly, and for this purpose we are actually dividing different codes are there. So there is two different code. One is by creating the object of frame class, that is called association, and the second one by extending frame class inheritance. So we are going to see how are the different encoding and some more features are there. That is, we can write the code on swing inside the main. That is our main. We can write inside the main or constructor or any other method. Okay. Let me go more Eclipse. Okay. Now this is the first program for your example. This is named as swing association, and I wrote in this this code in some package called kp.cst.swing. So here we directly total javax.swing package imported here, and this J frame. Here is a J frame, that means you already used frame as frame, but not J frame. Since it is a swing application, so we are using J frame. Now it is a this code is written under or inside the constructor. So our constructor is here, swing association. Since swing association, this is just name, so you can give any other name to it. So here J frame and J button is used. Now it is a where the button will appear. This is the button's position, and the next one, first two are the button position, and second is its height, width, etc. And this is a essential part, that is exit on close. Okay. Now let me run this. So if I run the Eclipse, this applet, this window is appeared, and here you know the swing association is the title bar, and click, there is a button also appeared. Now this is association example. This was, now this is swing inheritance. I named it as swing inheritance because here we are inheriting a class is doing by extends frame. So it extends J frame. So here in the previous code, look in this line, frame is with new J frame swing association. Okay, so here is an object is created. Okay, but in this code there is no such line is here. See, because it is extending the J frame. Since it is extending J frame, it already includes J frame. So here no need to another object creation. Fine. So it is also working in the same way here. Fine. Now I'm going to close this two applet window, and finally some larger code we are going to explain. it is a login page. So login page, first of all, okay, we can run it and we can show that how it is looks this. It is a login page, username is there, password. So these are labels or levels, and these are text fields, and these two are buttons. Okay. Now close it and try to understand the code. First of all, there is a special reason for these two lines. First two lines, J text field and J password field. Okay, so it is a special reason. We will explain some later. Now inside this, it is another type of writing. In previous two example, we are writing the code in constructor. Fine. So in association is our constructor, and we are writing the components under the constructor. Here also like this, but another approach is here, that is we are writing in main, right? So every such more possibilities are explained and for your convenience. Here we are again a frame. Since frame is masked for our container, as a container, after a container we can add here our requirements. And panel, I used here a single panel, that's why it's J panel, new panel, and no other panel is there. If required you can use more than one panel, obviously. Now here is our components are adding. Look, J level. Okay. J level, this name is user level, and the button name, level's name is user name. Now the position, 10 and 20 is the position, screen position. And 80 its width and 25 its height. So set bounds is the function to implement or to add our level, and these four are the parameters. So finally our text field, user text. This is statically defined in the above, at the above here. Okay, and finally we are declaring here the maximum size. I am taking here 20, and the position again 120. This is now another J level, that is password level. And here password text, that is password field. Okay, so J password field, obviously here all along with all comes along with the J. Now difference between text field and password field, it is very simple difference between them. If normal text field, then if you write type the characters, it will be shown on the screen. But if you use J password field, then the only some dots at the dot will appear in the screen. Fine. So these are again same as the before, positions only. Now the button, J button, login button. Login button, I gave the name like this. Fine. And this is again object creation, and with name login, and it is another button, that is receive. Now you already use some action listener. Actually, our swing in swing, we use the accent listener as the previous AWT. Okay, no differences here. The same functions, that is your login button, I mean the object name dot the action listener, same as before. And finally, here we are calling. So if it is called here, action listener is on, then this program will be executed. Now, but action performed. Okay. So action performed here. Look, string str is equal with AE. AE is this event. If we click on button, then action listener send execute this code. Okay, if this code is executed and we are clicking suppose the login button, then this get action command, okay, I mean its name here is written login in login button, then this login will be appear into this str. Fine. Now it will compare. It is if your form has only one button, then this if else is not required. But if you have more than one button and every button is clickable obviously, and then this if else is very much required, because it is the only way how a code will recognize that what button is pressed by. Now J option pane, that is you are going to use message dialog. Okay, so dialog again a container like frame. So this dialog will appear login successful. Here I want to say something that I didn't apply here any logic, just as an example it is shown. But if you design really a login page, then you should have some constraints, like if there is a valid username, valid password, then login successful, otherwise login unsuccessful. These all these are there. So I didn't write here E. And if there is a reset button in this example, so if there is a reset button, the doing reset, that is str equal reset, E only this line here. If str equals login, that means I press the login button. If it comes here, that means I press the reset button. This login, this reset, these are coming into this str. Clear? Now if we done reset, then we have to perform some extra task, that is the text field will be blank. Okay, so if we try this without these two lines, these two lines, I told you that special reason here to write these two lines. If we do not define these two field here, like if we defined in the main, then this function action performed cannot recognize them. Fine. So undefined symbol error, and that's why we statically defined them at the above. That's why these are now okay, and this text field will be remain blank. Let me run again. fine. Now I'm writing here something. Here's something. So login button, login successful because I didn't provide any logic here. You must provide it. And if I use this reset button, this reset button is written here to be blank. Now these are blank. Fine. Okay. Now I'm closing it, this applet window, and nothing more to say for these examples. I think you are going to implement it as soon as possible, and your assignments is there. Now write it, it is your assignment, and as soon as possible you implement it and inform me in Google Classroom. And for any doubt you wrote in Google Classroom, as soon as possible I sort out them. Thank you.